Hi, we're back. That's okay. That's okay.
Yeah, so, yeah, I was like in between my wish. So,
yes.
Like you said, we have this for knowledge in front of us, right? And that is why I think we are more aware. We see the effect, the construction, the whole industry has on us. So the whole point is, but there are also students, and even like some marketers, if I may say, pick up designs or will take inspiration, as we call it, from internet. So what do you have to say about that? How would you react to that?
So I think that it's very important for everybody, all professionals, to keep updated on what is being built around the world. So I think you have to be very clear about how you're learning. So, as far as the internet is concerned, I use it as a resource. So, you must, you know, whether it's for materiality, whether it's for the latest construction around the world, typologies or techniques, whether it's following, you know, certain studios you love or people that you really respect and you're watching. So that, you know, to me, looking at the work like that is of value. You know, if people are copy-pasting, that's not gonna last very long. I mean, you know, you're going to, as I said, you have to wake up every morning and love your job. A copy-paste is not love for your job. You know, what are you creating? At the end of the day, architecture is a creative field. If you're not creating, it's really not the job for you. You know, so, you know, I don't think we can judge people who are doing what they're doing. I think everybody has their own journey and they have to live with it. But if you really want to, you know, gain a sense of satisfaction of, you know, watching one of your actual creations being built, that's something else. That's what really shakes the soul. And then you watch people really engaging in the space and watching your buildings being lived in and kind of being worked. I mean, that's exciting. That's what architecture is about. So if you really want to understand and live the profession, then that's the way to do it, not the other way.
Yeah, that's Another thing I wanted to ask you was, like, what would be your one advice for students who just, like, had their degree in architecture, who've completed studying 5 years in their college? Do they go for PG? Do they do an internship job? Because they are so messed up in their head, they're like, where do I go? So
I've seen, obviously since COVID, everybody's now opening up, the market's opened up, you all can go back to studios. But we also saw this huge kind of wash of students going abroad, as it was as if the floodgates opened and everybody said, oh my gosh, the world is open, everybody's gonna go for their masters this year. And I think probably half of architecture students from India went abroad. So I mean, from somebody who's learned, I truly value the education and what I learned abroad, but I don't think that when I was abroad, India was where it is today. And if it was, I would never have left. So I think you're so lucky. You are in our country today, which is, I think, advancing way faster than any other part of the world. And so for me, it's quite confusing as to, unless, there is a real need or a specialization. And, God bless for those who want to go and study. But I think it's so important right after college, get into the workforce in your country. Work here, work 4, 5, 6 years, that's really, and trust me, once you've done that, you'll get into any school in the world. There's no doubt, because today the value that an Indian architect can bring after they work here, and if you work passionately and you do some interesting work, there's nowhere that won't kind of want to train you further. So my greatest advice would be, stay here, focus on where you are. You have such a big country, you have so many things to understand about it. I think there are great opportunities, whether, you want to work in an immersive environment and somewhere in like Hunashala, or you wanna be in a big city and you wanna do a studio work with studios like us or other studios, or whether you wanna just take off into the rural areas and just build for people, understand, live, you know, amongst people and really work there, you have so much choice today. So, you know, there is plenty to do at home, work, understand, learn and love your country, and then if you need to add on to your skills, go. Get the knowledge and come back home. This is really where it's at.
Come back home with me.
Yeah. Absolutely. I think, you know, there is so much happening for you all here. I'm so excited to be here to work every day. I mean, for you see the change. People are working on an international level. People want to do great things. They want to invest. They're looking at architecture finally, maybe in a different way. And, you know, if all of us bring back, you know, our knowledge and take the time and patience to understand our country and what it needs, you know, that's the greatest, it'll empower you as an architect. That's all you need.
I feel like on so many issues that we have faced, like we are, India as a country is facing, There is so much that architects can do and give back and improve, like complain that we are moving ahead, you know, it's in our hands.
Yes.
There's no point in you going abroad and settling there.
Yeah, I mean, I always say everybody's journey is different, and maybe different people will go abroad because, you know, some opportunity may take them, but I think today what India can offer you is everything we were looking for abroad and more, and you have the comfort of doing it at home. I mean, what more could you ask for? This is, you know, it is, as they say, our time. So take it.
We have such a palette of all kinds of places you could design wherever you want. You just choose and you go.
One of the things I love the most about being an architect is travel. I love traveling, and there is not one place that you go in India, even if you go 20 minutes outside a city, you will find something new. You go 20 hours, you know, driving, you will find something new. Take a 20-hour train ride, you will find something else new. Countries, because they have no culture, are building their own culture because they have none. Here we have it coming out of everywhere, out of the people, out of the land, out of the architecture, out of the history, out of the arts and crafts, I mean, is just sometimes I feel so overwhelmed. I'm like, oh my gosh, I do not have enough time in this lifetime to learn about everything. But yeah, it's so rich and it's really something we have to kind of, that's what should inspire you every day to go out and learn more. And you have it all here at home.
That's true. I think the major takeaway for our viewers and for me also will be to come back or just stay here and know your homeland. Because that is not what you're hearing when practicing architects say, you know? Some of them have a perception of you going and specializing in certain things, so your value as an architect is more.
Yeah.
So they have those things also.
Yeah, but I think you have, even if you are passionate about something and you do want to specialize, there are enough of people in India to teach you or for you to learn from. You know, you have the experts here who are doing it and you're learning in your context, right? So I interviewed a young girl who wanted to join our studio, and she had applied abroad and she did a semester there, and I noticed on her resume she said she left that program abroad. And I said, what made you leave? And she said, everything I was learning was totally out of context. It just didn't make any sense of where we live. So she left her college midway abroad, came back, reapplied to SEPT, went to SEP to finish her master's and started working. And I thought, wow. And she said, what I got most frustrated with is, I understand my people. I understand what I'm doing, and what they're teaching me is just so foreign. They're not able to grasp what I'm asking. And so, you know, that's another thing, you know, often, you know, it's not to say that you don't learn. Of course, as I said, I always believe and I value my education, which I was very fortunate to have from abroad, and it taught me so much. So no education is wasted. That's the bottom line. But today, if you can get some of that experience where you're from, you know, I mean, that is a great way to start, and perhaps life may lead you to develop on that anywhere in the world and, you know, get your skills to be better. But wow, can you imagine that coming back here and implementing it here in your own country? I mean, that's really, you know, the next step.
That is also on you saving resources, right? Because it is not easy and it's not for everyone to be
I think it's a very different life there. I think I love living in my country. I love that, you get a certain level of respect. There's a comfort. There is an understanding of the people you work with inherently. So these are things I love about being here, and I wouldn't change that for the world. You wouldn't get that anywhere else. So, did you practice architecture abroad as well, or just
No, so just the education, I studied abroad, but I worked as a lawyer abroad. I did a couple of internships there, and then the studio for the last 15, 16 years that I've been here, we work with a lot of foreign architects. So we've collaborated with Todd and Billy Cien, TWBT, who are building the Chicago Library. For the Obama Library, and then with KPF, Cohn Pedersen Fox, and OMA, Rem Koolhaas. So these are, amazing people to work with, and we're always learning. We're always learning. Those are the collaborations. So again, you can get that international exposure, but it is through collaboration today. And what an amazing thing that, the rest in the world are coming to us as partners on an equal footing, saying, "Will you partner with us for a project?" I think these are some of the international partnerships where they say they're learning from us, like we're learning from them. It is a symbiotic relationship. So I think that's what the future is. It is collaborations. It is about, understanding each other, learning from each other all the time, and then improving your own skill set and making yourself better at what you do.
And I think that also makes us very proud. Like in India, architects, it's taken us a time, it's taken us, some time to hold our ground, and we appreciate that, or we recognize that in some
No, absolutely. You're so right. I mean, there were many times when I began working in the profession where, we would always be the secondary architects for many international architects, or there would be many times where I would walk in with a team to present, and
They will look at my male colleagues to present, and they all of them would say, but actually it's our senior, and it would be me, a woman, who would present. So those are the things we had to kind of manage in the early times. Now it's completely, I think it's changed a lot. I think, it's much more of kind of an open practice, an open platform. People are much more aware. There's much more awareness. There's much more international standards that we hold each other to. So, it is changing, and it's changing for the better. But there are also challenges as architects. There are decisions we've got to make. Things like ethics. For us at SNK, ethics is a big thing. In fact, for every project we do, we have a clause about ethics that we've taken from the Council of Architecture that we put into our agreements that talk about honesty and transparency and, how do we work as professionals. And those are the standards that as architects in India we have to uphold if we are to change the profession together. So, how do we make ourselves, if each of us do this, and each of us are individuals, imagine the impact we make together. But that's the impact we've got to bring into the profession, is to bring up the standards, be ethical, have a sense of honesty, have a standardization. Those are the things that are going to really lift it.
Coming architects, so the students are looking forward to that, are trying to, better their work, are trying to just be like, even for internships, I see everyone like, oh no, have to do this, and they're just like, present the best of what they can, because there's already so much competition, right? It's also that thing. When everyone is like, oh, there's already so much, you kind of have to be very good to be recognized in some sense. Or else you like fall back. So that is also, that kind of adds pressure, but it also pushes you to be better.
Yeah, absolutely. Everybody has their talents, so don't worry about your talent. I think often people are so worried about looking at everybody else. Don't worry about everybody else. Just worry about yourself, but there is no